Hello, Anna. Hello, everyone. And thank you, Anna, for providing this wonderful platform for us. It's historical. It'll be a historical document that people will remember for a long time. And it's very valuable. And I've listened to so many of the testimonies on here, and my heart really goes out to all these beautiful people. And it's just fantastic. My name is Chris. I'm 70. I live in Pembrokeshire, in Wales, with my husband. We have two grown-up children and a lovely granddaughter. And I used to be a secretary, but what I like to do now is to write for children. So that's a little bit about me. Now, you know, all our thoughts on lockdown and on social distancing are the same, aren't they? I mean, this is a torture. You know, in the beginning, maybe people were a bit nervous and thought, well, maybe this is a good idea, social distance, lockdown, etc. But no. This is all about control. This is nothing to do with public health. Social distancing goes against all our natural instincts, all our basic needs. It is completely unnatural for human beings to keep apart from other human beings. We're social creatures, and we don't function well. And now, when the virus, COVID, is basically gone, I mean, you only need to look at the Office of National Statistics figures. You only need to look at the graph to see that it is out. We do not need to be social distancing anymore. But we're still told to keep your distance. You know, we've got tape all over the floor in the shops, arrows telling you to go this way or that way. Now when it's over, wear a mask, do track and trace, all these things. It's over. None of this is necessary. It is all about controlling us. You know, it's a torture. It is a torture. People are suffering mental illness in my own family, like others. In my own family, I don't want to say who, people are suffering acute and chronic anxiety. You know, it's awful. Depression, which has got much worse. Some days you don't know quite how to hold things together. There are physical symptoms coming from the anxiety. They're feeling very, very low, not knowing how to cope, bordering on OCD. And this is just as our family. This is multiplied, you know, thousands, millions of times across the world. And children, how, and I write for children, I'm very concerned about their development and that they should have joy. Children should have joy. This is their natural birthright. They should have joy and freedom and to develop. Now, how can they do this when, for example, now they for months they haven't been able to see their friends, and a lot of them have suffered a lot from this, been very frustrated, sad, anxious, and shown their anxiety in various different ways. In the school now, in the primary school locally, the plan is from when they go back to school now in September, is to put the children in small contact groups, pre-designated, and if you're But what do you do if your best friend is in another group? But you're not allowed to contact that group. You can't do that. So it's tough luck, you know? And that's how our children who are, you know, getting to the age when they start pulling away from their parents, start becoming more independent and want to try new things, where peer pressure is becoming much more important, the sharing and cooperating that you develop is hindered because the child can't relate fully with other people. This is very, very unhealthy, and what will be the outcome of it, I don't know, but it's not going to be anything good. So we really need to be there for the children, because they're the next ones coming up. We really need to be there to encourage them, to question everything, not take everything on face value what they're told. Question everything that they hear and that they're taught, and to be strong human beings. But I'm sure we all want to do this. I want to read just a short bit so I can make this a short video. This is the government's thinking behind the manipulation of our ideas. This is, comes from a book called Propaganda, written in 1928 by Edward Bernays, the father of public relations and propaganda. Between the wars, this is written. And here's a couple of sentences. The conscious and intelligent manipulation of the organized habits and opinions of the masses is an important element in democratic society. Those who manipulate this unseen mechanism of society constitute an invisible government, which is the true ruling power of our country. And then he goes on to say, it is they who pull the wires which control the public mind. Now, what do you think of that? We're the masses, we're the herd, we don't know what's good for us, we have to be told. Nonsense. We do know what's good for us. You know it in your gut. You know it in your instinct. So let's watch ourselves, keep hold of each other, and look after each other. We'll get through this. We'll get through this. Thank you. Bye-bye.